heads and minds security carefully. It is possible that the inhabitants, who are better off financially, will start looking for better quality housing and leave the estate completely. Those who are poorer will remain, and the rest of the accommodation to which conflict and other troubles may start to pile up. Both in the first cases, the city hall will have to intervene, and the government too. All these blocks of flats were built at the instigation of the state government. This type of housing was not planned by the cities themselves. Though the government may have to prepare for rebuilding a new housing program, there are large sections of the estate.
When it comes to the dismantling of Panamaki, it's taking no more complicated than this other type of building, says Professor Vitani of the Czech Technical University.
To bourání probíhá zásadovým způsobem. Jedno je, že se znovu ten objekt rozebírá od střechy dolů.
To je basically two methods of demolition. First is that the second is not to be driven. Then the condition is to be fabricated in parts from which the building is constructed. You can use them again either to accommodate some hardened surface or as a reinforcement, or even reuse them when building new structures. Or instead of the usual demolition by breaking up the original structure with special machinery, crushing it into small parts that can be used again with sandy pillar and concrete while building new structures. The iron rods can be recycled or reused again. We have both these choices. Of course, if you decide to use the second one, it's much more demanding in terms of energy and the environment. For example, such a building, gradually, is much better for the environment. Provided it is done by professional skilled workers, it is comparable to the careful demolition of a brick building. Depending on the carbonization of the concrete and corrosion of the metal rods reinforcing the structure, you can decide whether and how to use these dismantled parts. If you go this way, such demolition should actually be easier and less demanding in terms of energy.
Professor Yuki Vitani, there have always been the report that he is quite crime rate and social unrest. For architect Jan Castro, as mayor of Prague, this was one dark vision that luckily didn't come true.
As it's unlucky, we don't have any housing estate that could prevent a social or safety problem.
Here in Prague, there are no nuclear. There are internal communities in Bohemia, which have been devastated in part and neglect.
Our housing estates are quite well integrated into the rest of the city. However, it is true that the remoter is easier to reach by public transport. If I were to name some of the best ones, I'd probably name the Solidarita and Solidarity. An estate built right out of Asia, too, still using traditional materials, like in brick. Then perhaps stability.
These are among the first to build concrete houses in Poland, and the housing is rather primitive, but they are an excellent location. People who live in the finish, first to make them, very
yes, there are some really nice housing estates in Prague and other cities. Majority of them, however, are not that nice, and they have limited lifespan. Whether it's like it or not, they will have to deal with the problem that this type of housing ultimately poses. Lead Bohanka, Radio Prague.
And I thought we'd come up with all of that reporting on the service focus to the end of today's programme from Prague. You can find us at radio.cz. If you contact us, then our email address is email@radio.cz. We'll be glad to hear from you on Twitter. And of course, don't forget you can follow Radio Prague on Facebook and Twitter as well. This is WRMI, and of course, we'll be back.